Welcome back to another pen talk, and today I'm going to review this, the Flair Ink Tanker fountain pen in the blue color. So let's have a quick look around the pen and then we'll ink it up and do some writing samples, and I'll tell the things I like about it and the things I don't like about it. So let's start. So as you can see, it has a rubberized grip and has some markings over it, which looks pretty good. Also, it has the same nib like other Flair pens, and this is an Indian pen, and as you can see, it is pretty good and it also writes well. I had used it. After some time, I'll show you its main features, cartridge, and even I'll show you the box in which it comes. So you may think this is a barrel and you need to eyedropper it, but no, the barrel itself is a big cartridge and you can buy this separately. I'll tell the price of these things in the end, and also I'll show you the new cartridge. So now let's move on to the writing samples. So instead of putting in the cartridge, I am going to refill it using an ink syringe. So today I'm going to fill it up with Camlin Red. There is no fancy thing about this red ink, it's just a normal red ink. So just draw up some ink in the syringe. Then fill it up. So yeah, this is pretty much enough. It fits around 1.5 ml of ink, which is pretty decent. Now we'll keep it like this so that the ink goes till the feed. Now we'll have a look at the box in which it comes, and also I'll show you the cut. So the pen arrives in this packaging, this type of packaging. The pen with one cartridge comes with it like this. It already comes with a cartridge attached, and it looks like a barrel, and it even comes with an extra spare cartridge. So each cartridge costs about 20 rupees, but you cannot fit in the normal ink, normal Flair ink cartridge. So you have to buy the special cartridge. Also, the mouth is pretty wide open, so you can fill ink in this using a syringe and use it as an eyedropper pen. But you can buy this cartridge separately in whichever color you like. Blue, black, gray, purple, orange are the available colors. You can buy any one of these, and these cartridges cost 20 rupees, and the pen costs 70 rupees, and you get two cartridges with it and a pen, obviously, and you can afterwards buy cartridges if you want. So now I think the ink drew its way up to the feed. So now let's check whether it writes. So I am going to do the writing samples in this Classmate spiral notebook. The pages are pretty good and it is pretty fountain pen friendly. So let's check it out. The pen here is... Now the ink didn't draw. So... You can shake it. There is an agitator ball which pushes the ink. And now let's check whether it writes. Yeah, it writes. As you can see, there was some dried up blue ink in it. So the blue ink is coming out instead of the red ink which I filled. So I need to give it a bit more of shape. Now let's check. I had filled it with Camlin Red. The red ink still didn't came out, but it's fine, it writes. Now let's check out for normal writing. So, it writes pretty well, and for this price, you can expect this much only. So now let's check out fast writing. So, yeah, the feed keeps up pretty well. There was just a small skip over here. Otherwise, everything is good. Now let's check out for reverse writing. So, yeah, reverse writing is doable, but there are some skips, but still it's fine considering that this is a folded nib. And yeah, for the price of rupees 70, which is about a dollar, it's great. Now let's check out the wetness of the line. So yeah, it's pretty wet considering that this is a normal medium nib, and it is the Flair standard nib which is found in most of the Flair pens. Now let's check for any line variation. So there is no line variation, and yeah, the company doesn't advertise it as a flex nib or any sort of thing. Now let's check for the wetness. So yeah, it is the Flair normal ink and it's fine. So yeah, it works pretty well. And I am really impressed with this pen. Now let's talk about the things which I don't like about it. I have used this pen for almost a year, and as you can see, there is a crack in the cap, but not a great deal. You can stick it, and sometimes the inner cap lining comes out, but that's not a great deal. You can just stick it back with some glue. And also, the cap liner works pretty well. It keeps the nib wet for a longer period of time. The things which I like about it, the rubber grip is pretty good, and you can get a great grip over the pen while writing for longer sessions of time. Also, it holds about 1.5 milliliter of ink, and if you want, you can fill it with any ink. And if you do not want to fill it with syringe or have any mess, you can even put a normal cartridge in it. So yeah, this pen is pretty good for its price, and I would recommend it to all of you if you like ink pens or fountain pens. So thank you. Let's meet in another video, and please stay tuned. And also like, share and subscribe to my channel.